What you really need to do, if you want to close the skills gap and make a case for STEM or skilled trades or both, you have to put it out there, you know, and you have to show people enthusiasm, and you have to show people the opportunities, and you have to talk about it.
Pennsylvania College of Technology and hundreds of other entities did just that by exhibiting at the recent USA Science and Engineering Festival in Washington, D.C.
Really exciting to share all the different possibilities as far as the education that we offer with all the prospective students, and just to see them get excited about the material as well.
The three-day festival attracted approximately 350,000 people, making it the largest event in the United States devoted to the skilled trades and STEM, careers involving science, technology, engineering, and math.
This festival is all about inspiring the next generation. We're here, and we're the founding and host sponsor of this activity, really to expose kids to science and engineering and technology.
Every one of the booths here can be the booth that sparks that, hey, this is cool, I need to go do this moment in a young person's mind, where if they hadn't come, they would never know it.
The 20 by 50 foot Penn College exhibit included three hands-on activities featuring a virtual welder, an electric Camaro built by automotive technology management students, and cars controlled by tablets.
It goes like at least 5 miles per hour.
No matter what age, they see everything from the welding to the car that it's attractive to them and say, I might be interested in something like that.
The nation needs more individuals interested in the trades and STEM-related careers to close the skills gap. Many of the 3 million plus unfilled jobs in the country require such a background.
Things are changing so quickly that can create a gap, especially if we're not able to work closely with academia in order to keep that loop tightly closed.
The single biggest challenge is finding people who are willing to learn a new and useful trade. That's the trick. Gap doesn't close until that happens, and that doesn't happen until perceptions around work start to change.
The more people who train in STEM at any level, right, any level, the more people who have that sort of basic vocabulary and skill set are better equipped to do anything in society.
Several Penn College students enrolled in technical majors served as ambassadors for STEM education and their school.
I think it's really cool to be here with a bunch of people who are serious about technology and math and engineering, and that's what this is, you know, all of those combined.
I love doing things for the school, and I think very highly of everybody there, and so I love to talk to people about it, and I love to try to get them interested in college in general.
While it's difficult to measure the festival's direct impact on the skills gap and enrollment, Penn College and the STEM field can count on at least one edition in the coming years.
Before I came here, I really didn't know what I wanted to do, but now I definitely want to get a Penn College.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.